Good morning everyone, welcome back to the vlog. It's Sunday morning, race day, and believe it or not, I have stage fright. Why do I have it? Well, I don't have it for any race in Serbia. I don't have it for any road race. I didn't even have it for mountain bike world championships last and previous years, but it's today because I have a special goal and I need to be in top 3. And you know how it says, after the rain, the sun will come up, and that will happen after this race. I just need to start the race and everything will be clear. And I'm actually going, of course, for the straight win, no doubts, so we will see. It was raining the whole night, now it's only just slightly rain. And since the course is pretty flat and there is no technical parts, I think there are only maybe some small stairs, Vlada told me, but we will see about that because it was raining and the water carries everything, maybe they will change the course. The rain will help me because that will make the course harder and then you will see the bigger differences, who is better and who is not. Right now I'll prepare some breakfast. I have some bananas, oatmeal, yogurt over there in freeze, and I'll chill here a little bit more. I have 3 hours before the start just to calm down. Something like this. Yogurt. And of course, if you want, if you're going on some distance training, you can put some Schwarz in it, but this is one example of superb ultimate weight loss oatmeal. By the way, I just wanted to show you, since I'm staying in Vladimir Kuvalja's home, he was perspective cyclist as junior, he was in top 20, maybe even in top 15 in the world. He's very experienced, but as he told me last night, he was just too lazy. Now he is one of the best organizers of the races in Europe. He's involved in organization of many, many races. He's the vice president of Balkan Cycling Union. He's also working on the World Championships for Masters this year. He's really, really good at it and really well deserved. And here are some of his rewards, awards, medals, everything. Just, you know, it's some nice. And what's most interesting is this, his first bike. Really, Vlado, thanks for everything you did this night and before. You're such a great guy. Thanks. Yeah, it stopped raining. But since it's still too early for me to go on the race, and I'll just go to these stairs and just feel my legs. Walk them up and down a couple of times, that will improve my blood circulation and prepare me for the race. Oh yeah, this hill will definitely make them bleed.
Let's go!
So Vlada did draw me a very nice illustration how to get on the course, but I think that navigation is level 21st century. This and this actually look the same. Yes. Amazing job. Here we are, guys. Here we are. To be honest, it doesn't look even close to flat, as they told me.
Sada u imanjim uzrasnim kategorijama,
Bravo, Ivane!
I'm already preparing the car for coming home because we'll put my mountain bike and Dusan's road bike inside so we can full speed on the highway. Even though they told that the course is really fast and that the juniors rode for 7 minutes per lap, and if you calculate that with 12 laps, that's going to be less than an hour and a half. But of course, if I want to win, I'll need to go on course and see it. And because I want to save battery of my GoPro, I won't record that. And because I have 1 hour before the start, I will end all vlog stuff right over here and I will put you into highlights. And let's hope for the best, guys. Thank you and let's go.
Thank you.
How to be a dickhead 101 by Ognjen Ilić.
That moment when you realize that the hotel you're staying in doesn't have 4 stars but only 3.9 online review stars. But anyway guys, here we are at Istanbul airport. As I told you, tomorrow I'll talk more about why we are here and why it's not so great trip, but now when we come into our rooms, I'll talk about today's race. If you want, you can end the most interesting parts of the vlog now, but I think that it's really crucial to know how it went because it's such a big result for me and stay. It's 2 o'clock after midnight and we just came here in hotel rooms. And by the look on my face, and definitely you could expect that I'm tired AF, and we had to carry on our luggage and bikes here to hotel, which is around 3 km from airport, and that took us a long time. But anyway, now spending some time with this best recovery food you can imagine. That's just one of rare sweets that I eat. It's just perfect. Anyway, about the race. Well, the course wasn't that flat as they told me before. It definitely had good descent with some roots and it was really sharp corners, definitely not easy. And it had uphill with a couple of corners and that wasn't easy either. Of course, it wasn't hard and that was a small problem because I couldn't just push everything I have and to try to break away from other guys, because after big climb, after big descent, there is flat section and the group in a flat section is always faster than one guy. So I had a great start and after that we held together for the first 2 laps, 5 riders, those Italian, Czech and French rider and Bosnian rider Mahmic and me. And after that, on the 3rd lap, I had a small crash that really worried me about a little bit, because I again bent my seat slightly towards the side and my brake levers, but I fixed pretty quick, but I catch the other guys only in the next lap. And yeah, it was a little bit something to consider because, you know, I invested couple of months and a couple of weeks just before this race. I tried everything I could to rest the maximum, all the massages, all the stuff, all the rest I invested, and to spend it out just for with small crash, that would be such a stupid mistake. But of course I motivated myself and gave it full gas. After that we held together pretty much. Everyone attacked on some parts, but no one really escaped. In the entering of the last lap, Italian rider or Czech rider attacked, but we all followed. But on the last ascent, the French rider did drop out a little bit. Then we came on the last part, flat road, actually slightly uphill road till the finish, and I saw that French rider was a little bit behind, and as you know, my goal was to be in top 3, which will allow me to have that scholarship payments from Minister of Sport or however that's called, and I just wanted to lead out a little bit, just not to get catched by the French rider. Then the Czech rider was riding just behind me, or at the moment on the side, and as soon as he started to sprint, I sprinted out maximum. That was around 300 meters till the finish. And very soon I dropped him, but the Italian rider was on my wheel, and when I looked, he just went on the left side, but he couldn't pass me. And that's all, I won the race. It was amazing experience, all the people around the course, the organization, everything was perfect. Everyone was cheering me, which of course I would do if anyone was racing with the guys who are not from this region. Really, I appreciate it. Thank you very much, everyone, all the Bosnian people. It was really amazing and you really helped me. And special thanks to Mario Kojic, who was my guy in the feeding and tech zone. I don't know really what to say. I'm super happy. Win on the UCI race.
I think I haven't won UCI race for 2 years. It's just wow, I don't know what to say. I felt like a star and people really told me that it is like that, and it's really amazing, and still it is amazing. This will help me, and it proved me really important stuff, which is never give up. And that's all. I don't know what else to say. Super, super happy. Really, thank you, Buan, my coach, who predicted and planned everything very successfully. That's all for today's vlog, or actually yesterday's vlog, because today is actually tomorrow. So I will talk tomorrow about all this new trip, but stay tuned. Thanks for watching and see you in another video.